Well, I don't know. Mr. Jones, what do you have to say for yourself?
Look, what's all this stuff about a chainsaw? I just happen to be sitting there with my Ruger 9mm pistol on my lap when this fella comes through the window, so I shot him. How did I know he was the mailman?
Bang, bang, that's all the time.
What do you mean we run out of gas?
What will get involved?
So, not for these creatures, the constant babble of music television. For them, it's salt water and plankton. Year in, year out.
Nel da pisto! Comprende? Io non parlo italiano!
Coming next, the Glam Metal Detectives. Also tonight, Betty's Mad Dash. The Big Steve. Bloodsports. And Colin Corleone.
Glam Metal Detectives. Your mission is to save this planet's ecology with your top hit records. That's all for now.
England's won what? The Soccer Football World Cup. And they say miracles don't happen.
Everybody down. Hip to the beat, more than sufficient. Justice for all. Everybody up. Oh, hi, Ringo. Nice to see you.
Thanks a lot. Great gig, guys. All you need is love.
Well, they certainly loved you tonight. Listen.
Listen to the sound of one man smiling. Hey, do you want to come down to speak with me and Mooney?
Yeah!
Sorry, guys. Party's off. Something's come up.
Oh, but Mark, it's our last night in England.
Yeah, I want to party with my sister Mary.
This concerns your sister.
Mary Pippins?
Exactly. I've just received a phone call. Mary Pippins has gone missing. She's been kidnapped by a hunchback, boss-eyed beef eater with a raven.
You crazy guy.
Really.
You really must stop repeating yourself, young man. Now, what's the plot?
I want to go to the Never Never Land.
You're not going anywhere until you've tidied this place up. It's so dark in here. That's no good for your eyes. Look at them. Ah. Now open your mouth, let me see your tongue. Yes, just what I thought. Cod liver oil, that's what you need. And don't forget to wash behind your ears. Oh, dear me. Now, who's been drawing on the floor?
I'm glad you brought that up.
Fields, valley, a big car, Rolston RB1.
Yeah.
A big house, a swimming pool, and what's that?
A splat factory. That's it. That's my plan.
Splat? What's that?
It makes you feel really, really, really.
Really, really, really.
Shut up. So what do you say, babe? You and me? A splat factory in the Never Never Land? And the best thing of all is, we'll never, never, ever get caught.
I think you've forgotten one thing, Mr. Brocade. What happens if the picture fades away? You'll be trapped inside.
I got that covered. Len's gonna varnish us in. Ready, Len?
Ready.
Ready, Pip?
If you'd have washed behind your ears and read my book, you'll know the most important thing. You can't go to Never Neverland without the Mary Pippins back.
Why?
Now let's examine the facts. Mary Pippins was last seen with a beef eater. Bill, run a check on all the beef eaters you can find. Dune?
We're gonna find her. You've gotta help us. Who were her friends? Where did Mary Pippins go? What were her personal habits? How well did you know her?
Did she have a boyfriend? If so, what did he do?
Was he a cop? Who were his friends? Did he cheat on her or did she cheat on him?
Steady
or did
on, they both? All right, all right.
I'm sorry.
She left home when she was 15. She couldn't settle anywhere. She just kept living out of a handbag and getting jobs as a nanny.
Mom.
And there are other things.
Yeah, Mom. I'm getting a readout of the known criminal hunchback beef eaters.
I could be any one of these known criminal hunchback beef eaters.
Go back.
Which one?
Go back. That one.
Splat at it? Well, that can only mean one thing.
Yes?
Shut up and listen. I'm talking. Never mind who I am. I'm Ralston Brocade. I'm in a baker's in Pudding Lane with Pippins and a box of swans. Look, get across here with that magic bag, or Pippins goes up with the rest of London. Got it?
He mentioned a bag. What's so special about this bag, Doon?
Well, it's a carpet bag. She can get things out of it.
What kind of things, Doon?
Mary has special powers to produce things from the bag. Things larger than the bag itself.
You mean bigger than the bag from which they came?
What, like tables and chairs?
Bigger.
Bigger? So if this bag was to get into the hands of Ralston...
Exactly. But if we don't find it and get it to him...
He'll set my sister and the city of London on fire.
Tired of having nowhere to hang your clothes? Try a coat hanger from Johnson's Coat Hangers. Your clothes may never look the same again.
Coaties. A large selection of new and used coaties at Barry's Coaties. 12-seaters and 36-seaters. Good runners, all reconned aftershocks, easy turns available. Barry's Coaties, Wolverhampton 277. I wouldn't drive anything else.
So let me get this straight. She has a strange ability to take things out of the bag larger than the bag itself.
Exactly.
Wow.
Blow me down! Bless me, cotton socks, same as I'm standing here. Quick foot, don't you know? What a sight I did see. A big bag. I bent down to pick it up. I was just about to half inch it, and I gets to thinking, me poor old mum what's got rickets, and what use blokes to done for charity and all that thing to myself. Well, it's only right and proper, as taters as the night may be. I sees this bag sitting there, bright as a button, big as a cream cake, starving as I may be. What with Pippin's gone missing and all, since you sorted me all right tonight at the gig, Mary Pippin's bag.
You're saying this is Mary Pippin's bag?
Same as I'm standing here. Well, if it ain't me old mate, Doon Pippins.
Hello, Artful.
Okay, here's the plan. Are you ready, Doon?
12, 11, 10, 8,
21,
20, 16, 8, 5,
19.
5, 19, 7, 9, start again, 3. Five!
Your counting is atrocious.
Brocade, if you want to see the bag, send Pippins out.
Go on, Ray, tell him. Never mind the legs, you randy little crow. Get back in here.
What about me?
I'm not taking you with me, you filthy, stinking, double-crossing little rook.
Here, you throwing buns at my raven?
You, hey! I got the bag! I got the bag! Geronimo!
Here I am in Never Never Land!
And you're never ever gonna get me!
Draw a cage around him. That's it.
Wait a minute! No, don't leave me!
Ha! Now you will never, ever, ever get out.
Please! Please don't leave me!
dances. I had a really, really, really awful time. Funk and justice for all. Let me tell you about funk and justice for all.
What's that, Commander? Our new song is number one in Texas, America. Well, that's good, because we're playing there next week.
Then I had a drink, cause I was Thursday. Then the man dad come in said that has it was God for the man's nice.
Kumbaya, kumbaya,
kumbaya. Oh my God! We're all gonna die!
So for $2,000, you will hold your breath for 10 minutes. Let's just check that safety buzzer once more. We're gonna be withholding oxygen from this man right after this.
Do you want peace of mind? Why not join us now? The Moses Convention.
It's great in here. If you believe in miracles, why not call us?
The Moses Convention. It could happen to you.
Why not call us?
Yes, it's great in here.
57, 58, 59, 60,
61,
62,
63,
64, 65.
Well, there seems to be a slight technical hitch with the price of love. Meanwhile, here's some music while we...
And it's okay. We've got our medical team here, Bill and Dave. They're fully trained in the art of resuscitation. Look how fast they move. Yes, folks, this show's coming to you live, and so is Ralph.
This is great. Still to come, Betty's Mad Dash, The Big Steve, and Colin Corleone. You get 62% more laughs on GMD.
Hello and welcome to the National TDA Championships. Tonight we're coming to you live from Croydon. Let's go over to Bob now, who's got Jimmy Nittle. Hello, Bob.
And here we are, South London's live TDA, as it happens. The boy now skips over to TR7, round the old Volvo. He's looking for a good car here. It's going to be the Uno, yes. He's definitely going Italian. He smashes the window, has a quick look round. No one's watching. Into the passenger seat. What a clean entry into the car. And look at this. What fantastic ignition control. Had a key. Oh, high drama. He's only got a driven in the bus lane and ended up colliding into a police car.
Well, a bad result for young drama. Jimmy. Ted, what went wrong?
Well, I mean, you know, when it... You and I both know, Del, when it comes to TDA, the boy Nuttall there, he's one of the finest, really, isn't he? And certainly in terms of up-and-coming TDA men. But, it's page one. It's such a fundamental error there. He's driven in the bus lane and he's hit the police car. And what can you say, really? I mean...
Is it time we looked at the whole bus lane rule?
Yes. They should look at the situation and say, well, do we need the bus lane or don't we need it? And they should be very clear, I think, about, and I have said this before, and I will say this again, that you've got to look at the situation.
Would you stick your neck out and...
I'd stick my neck out and say that. Scrap the bus lane.
Well, there you have it. A bad night for Jimmy Nuttall. Join us next week for the Junior Bully Boy Championships from St. Etheridge Comprehensive Gateshead. Good night.
There's something lurking deep in the ocean.
It's got fins and it's not friendly.
It lives off fear.
It's living off our fear.
Terror on Big Fin Bay. Straight to video. Rent it now.
That is Mad Death.
Mommy? Bobby?
Goodness gracious, it's Dan, dear. What are you doing here, Petal?
I'm home on holes, Mommy. Have you come to collect me?
I'm afraid we're in a bit of a tight jam. Here, take the Bentley and meet us by the further fourth and the fifth.
Further the fourth and
yes,
the fifth?
Yes, yes, it's an old bridge and they're always painting it. Are you all right for pocket money, darling?
Oh, yes, thank you, Mommy. I've been saving all term.
Yes, let's have it then. See you at the seaside, Poppet.
Bye, Mommy.
Bye, Denzel. Maisie, get on! Coming!
Be on the third, the fourth, the fifth, the second. Oh, come on!
Jump on that train!
He's got coal on the brain, he has.
Never mind the flim-flam, Grandad. Get this train moving at once, or I'll be forced to shoot you and your idiot coal-obsessed son.
Right-o! Shovel the coal in, shovel the coal in!
Make the train go!
Ladies are under arrest.
It looks like we're in trouble, Maisie.
Is this the end of the line for Betty and Maisie? Don't miss next week's gripping episode of Betty's Mad...
Starting tomorrow night, our new 36-part series, a chilling tale of intrigue and espionage in The Tree.
Feeling frail? Think you're past it? Well, Mickey doesn't, and he's a meal on wheels.
Hey, special weekday race for OAPs too.
Call Mickey on 0898-6969-69.
And I'll change your bedpan too.
Dial for Mickey.
Oh!
As you may have heard, Morag, the presenter of The Big Me, has retired from this series. But tonight we start a new season with Steve Whirl and the Big Steve.
Thank you, thank you. You're too kind. Talent like this comes along, but
once in a life.
Uh-huh.
This is very exciting.
Oh, yeah, good. Ladies and gentlemen, it's so exciting. You've got to watch it. He's just fabulously talented, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, God, you've got to watch it. Really, really.
So let's give a nice warm welcome.
Warm welcome.
And only Dickie Dick.
Hi, Dickie.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
With my show, yep. Backstabbing bastard!
Steve, don't go changing. You gonna sing for us tonight?
Hey, is Jesus black? Only kidding. I'd like to start by singing a great song of a great friend of mine, a great friend of yours too, the late legendary Bobby Marley.
Oh, take it away, yeah. Dickie.
All right. No woman, no cry. You look beautiful, honey.
No, woman, don't cry. You know, quite funny, when I was younger, you know, my dad came in to me when I was on my cot, and he said, you know, Morag, you really have got what it takes. And you know, I know people tell you're talented all the time, but I really have got what it takes. I have.
Purple haze.
It's a jamming, Steve. You ready to jam? I'm ready to jam.
The jamming.
Come on, jamming. Everybody. Jam.
We hope you like jamming too.
Yay.
Because we're jamming.
Jamming.
You know something else? I've got talent. You know, I've got what it takes. I've told them time and time again. And I'll tell you what, I'll be back.
And now, the life and times of Colin Corleone.
It's always a great joy when there's another addition to the family. I think we should celebrate.
Yeah, maybe get something to eat, eh, Cole? £10? Where are we going?
There's a new place on the high street, Ziggy's.
Yeah, let's hope there ain't no mooks there, huh?
Like a bridge over troubled water, it will ease your mind. Like a bridge over troubled water, it will ease your mind.
Hey, Mr. Zavaroni, we really enjoyed your show.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, Mr. Corleone would like you to be a guest at his table.
Oh, I'm sorry, it's late, and I have to get to Ostley. The last bus leaves in 3 minutes, and there's no night bus.
Hey, listen, we take care of the buses.
Thank you, really, there's no need.
No, you don't understand. Mr. Corleone, he thinks you have a great talent, and he has a lot of friends in the music business, so...
Well, 2 minutes, then.
Boss, this is Tony Zavaroni. Tony, this is the boss.
Hello.
Tell me, Tony, are you happy?
Oh, it's okay. I have this gig once a week, but it's a start for me, and I'm happy.
You cry like a baby! Listen to me, Tony, you're gonna be somebody! Instead of playing to all these moves.
Who are you?
Hey! Hey!
Clemenza, it's okay, it's been a long time.
Yeah, ain't that the truth?
The boy's hungry, give him some of your food.
Huh?
Give him some of your food.
Why me?
Give him some of your food.
No, not my food, your food!
Hey, the boss didn't say for me to give him some of my food. The boss said for you to give him some of your food!
Tony, eat.
No, it's okay, really, I've eaten.
Now, tell me, who's paying you to sing here?
I think you better talk to Mr. Pratt.
Hey, sit down, Mr. Savaroni.
Don't worry, I'm gonna take care of this guy.
No, he's fine. His wife, all the time, she give me a kidney and a steak of bloody put, followed by jam roly-poly.
When you wake up in the morning, this man will give you what you want. I give you my word.
Well, it was nice to meet you, Colin.
Call me Godfather.
Godfather, yeah. You and your friends, like in the film, yeah? And the voice is just like that, too. It's good.
Hey, Rocco, bambino. He loves that little horse. It's all he ever talks about. Ciao, Mr. Pratt.
Hiya, kid. Nice horse.
Mr. Ziggy, I'd like to thank you for inviting me to your place.
It's open to the public and I didn't invite you. So what's all this about, Tony? You mates of
his... The boy seems like an angel. And all you give him is a steak and kidney and a pud.
If Tony don't like it, he can piss off, all right?
It makes me very sad that you take this attitude. I came here to do business with you. I don't want that our family should fall out over this matter.
And I don't want for you should fall out of that window, you Marvin Brandy Natter, you.
Hey, shut up, kid. You're getting hysterical.
I've had enough of you. I'll give you a job. I'll give you food. 25 quid. You haven't even got a work permit. And this is how you thank me, is it? If you're sending these wankers round.
They've cut off my horse's head.
Shut up, kid. You're getting hysterical. Now, you out.
They're putting too much ketchup on your bed.
Boy, you sick wankers. You want Godfather? You go. Come on!
It's over. There's no more Mr. Potato Head. I promise. And I've just heard from the hospital. Julie's gonna be okay.
Now at the time at 3:04, it's time to go over for another half hour of stand-up comedy to jigglers with Willie Witless.
Are you well? Hey, the royal family, oh, they're Princess Diana and Ferguson, Diana and Fergie, right? All that money and everything, eh? What about that then?
Get off!
I'm not funny, you're funny anyway,
because... How much are you getting for doing this then?
Get my money back. Anyway, are you well?
Next week, the Glam's in Texas.
What happened to me?
Where's Mark?
He's upstairs. Come and have a look. Strange.
Something happened in Texas.
Yeah. Prepare yourselves to smile.
And this time, there's no answer, no. Injustice, injustice,